Hi everyone. In today's credit conversation, we are here to discuss a very important topic in the current environment, which is the health of India's power sector. I am joined with my colleagues Sudip Sural and Rajat Bahl from CRISIL Ratings team to take the discussion forward. Our study indicates largely that the risks are rising on account of two fronts. One is the generation sector, where our study indicates that about 46,000 megawatt of capacity and about 75,000 crore of loans to these capacities are at risk. On the distribution front, our study indicates that the total debt of the state DISCOMs has risen to about 4.5 lakh crore. And we also see a situation where the financial restructuring plan that was implemented over the last 2 years is now coming to an end. So we will look at some of these issues and challenges in a little more detail. Let's start with the generation sector first. The generation sector has seen a lot of capacity addition over the past few years. However, yet we see that a lot of that capacity is underutilized. There are challenges that we have seen continuing over the past few years in the sector. How do we see those challenges is something which is important, and how is the what is the exposure of India's financial sector towards these is something that becomes important.
So talking about the generation sector, I think we had highlighted in 2011 that availability of coal and gas is becoming an issue for the generators. In addition, in the last 3 to 4 years, a couple of more risks have emerged. Those risks are the aggressive bidding done for getting into new projects, and the recently allocated coal auctions, where again we have seen aggressive bidding in order to win coal blocks. The second issue that has emerged on the generation front is the ability of DISCOMs to enter into long-term commitments for the purpose of purchase of power. And we have seen in the last couple of years that the PPAs announced and signed by DISCOMs have been on a declining trend. This leaves some part of the capacities of, especially of the private sector, at risk because they are without a PPA. Having a PPA helps because it gives a lot of stability to the cash flows of the generators, and it also enables them to obtain coal under the fuel linkage. Coming back to the availability of coal, we have seen that the government has taken steps to increase coal availability, especially of Coal India. And while along with imports and along with the recently auctioned coal blocks, the availability of coal in the power system will increase, we will still have a situation where the private capacities commissioned post 2009 will be operating at a sub-optimal PLF of about 45%. On the gas front, again, the government has taken steps in order to make gas available for thermal gas projects under a subsidy from the Power System Development Fund and a lower cost of gas. However, again, here, unless the generators are able to get a principal moratorium, they will be at risk. And there continues to be some part of the gas capacities which are stranded without any PLF. So when you add all these buckets up, namely the fuel availability issue, both on the coal and the gas front, the aggressive bidding done in order to get coal blocks as well as in order to win projects, and the fact that some part of the capacities are without long-term power purchase agreements, the total sums up to about 46,000 crores of megawatts, which is at risk for the generation sector.
With the expectation of an increase in demand for power, the banks and financial institutions have continued to increase their exposure to the power sector at a healthy rate. However, with the structural reforms not keeping pace with the credit growth, we are at the current situation where about the debt to the 46,000 megawatt projects is currently weak. However, we do not believe that the entire 2.1 lakh crore of the exposure would be at risk, given that banks have certain provisions with them. There are projects which have a very strong promoter who can support the repayment for a large portion of these loans. In addition to that, banks have a flexibility of structuring the repayments of many of these projects, which can make them viable. So net, we believe that about 75,000 crore of this debt could be at risk to the banking system.